In this video, I'm going to be seeing how far I can get my Tesla Model 3 on 5 kilowatt hours of electricity, how much that's going to cost you, and also whether hypermiling is going to make any difference whatsoever. For those of you that aren't familiar with what 5 kilowatt hours of electricity will get you, it will make you 45 cups of coffee, it will wash your clothes 5 times, or it will cook a roast dinner for you for about an hour and a half. Now, to make this video even more interesting, I know you're thinking, how much more interesting can a video get about 5 kilowatt hours of electricity? I'm going to be comparing my normal driving style, where I don't really care much about my energy use, to hypermiling the Tesla Model 3, where I'll reduce the excess weight in the car, make sure my tyres are pumped up to the correct pressure, aero wheels are on, and the HVAC is off. So let's see how we do in the Tesla Model 3 5 kilowatt hour challenge. The latest Tesla Model 3 is one of the most efficient cars money can buy. Depending on which model you get, the MPGe is rated at just over 140 MPGe. But what does that mean in the real world? Well, I'm currently driving as I normally would, so my aero wheels are off because I wanted to mix up the appearance a little bit. I've been a bit lazy in carrying around excess weight in my boot, not around my belly. I haven't checked my tyre pressures recently, so they're currently sitting at 40, and they should be 42 PSI when all tyres are cold. And the HVAC is on because it's quite a hot sunny day, and I don't want to get too hot and sweaty. So how far am I going to be able to drive with 5 kilowatt hours of electricity? Now, my Tesla Model 3 is the late 2019 version, which Tesla say has an MPGe of 133 miles per gallon. To put it another way, they say that 100 miles should use 25 kilowatt hours. So by my reckoning, 5 kilowatt hours should get me 20 miles. We'll see whether Tesla are telling any porcupines in their statistics or not today. Interestingly, for me at least, electric cars actually do better in city driving when it comes to MPGe than they do on highway. Whereas for combustion cars, that's completely flipped round, because combustion cars don't like the start-stop of city driving. Because it's a lovely, hot, sunny day, I'm out driving around in the countryside, which I think is going to be a nice combo mix of kind of like city versus highway. When I go through the villages, it's probably more going to be like city driving, sticking to 30 miles an hour. And then when I get out onto the open road between the villages, I'm more likely to achieve highway speeds. I've also bought a new diagnostic tool, so we'll be able to precisely see when we get to 5 kilowatt hours of battery usage, and I won't have to rely on just the percentage that's on the screen. This tool actually lets you do really deep dives into all the statistics of your Tesla Model 3. So if you're a geek like me and love that, I'm going to be doing loads of that in future videos. So feel free to click that subscribe button straight away, and then you'll be able to see all those videos. It can even tell you how much charge the Tesla Model 3 has taken in its lifetime and where that charge has come from. So now I know how much regen braking I've produced in its lifetime, how much supercharging, how much charging on my home charge has been created. There's loads of stuff in there, and I'm only just touching the surface with what I'm exploring. Right, on to see how this actually performs. Right, we're not far off 5 kilowatt hours now. So how I've done this, I've included regen braking because that's used when it calculates watt hours per mile and the MPGe. And because of my new diagnostic tool, I can actually tell you how much regen braking I've made during this journey. And it's quite surprising, but I'll come to all of that at the end. Right, we're just looking like we're about to tick over. And there it is, right, 23.3 miles. So we've smashed what Tesla predicted at the 20 miles, which is good. It means the MPGe is actually over what Tesla's rated it for. I wonder how much of a difference hypermiling is gonna make. So I'm gonna head home now. I'm gonna unpack everything that I carry around with me that's a waste of time. Gonna pump up my tires, put the aero wheels back on, and then rehydrate because I'm turning the air conditioning off, and I imagine it's gonna get pretty toasty in here. Right, time to be super careful with the acceleration and make the most out of regen braking. Now, the regen braking is on its maximum, which is 85 kilowatts if you use it correctly, which is huge, isn't it? And because of my new diagnostic tool, we'll be able to see just how much regen braking contributed at the end of the journey. So the tyres are now at 42 PSI, which is the recommended amount by Tesla. I've turned the HVAC off, which I've already started to notice and get quite clammy in here. I've taken all the excess stuff out of my boot, so I'm not carrying around all that additional weight. And I've put the aero wheels back on. I'm driving exactly the same route as I did before, up to the point where hopefully I will exceed what I did last time, and then we'll just carry on into new territory on that extra few kilowatt hours that I've got left at the end. Now, I'll be honest, on the first trip, I did get stuck behind some Sunday drivers. Funny that, because it's actually a Sunday. So they were driving quite slow. So I think on this experiment, my driving style isn't going to have a massive impact. Either way, I've set the driving style now to chill rather than standard, which just dumbs down the accelerator a little bit and is meant to save you a little bit of energy. So we'll see if that makes a difference. So on the last trip, we got watt hours per mile of 214. The Tesla actually worked out as 208. I'm not quite sure why the difference was, because I was using that tool to have a look at it. But either way, that works out as a huge 157 MPGe, which smashes what Tesla thought my Model 3 should achieve, which was 133. Even in city driving, it thinks I should have achieved 140 MPGe, which is awesome. So what does that translate to into costs? Well, if you're an octopus paying the 5p per kilowatt hour rate, 5 kilowatt hours is going to cost you 25p, which works out as just over 1p per mile on that basis. Now, if you're interested in getting Octopus, I've put my referral code in the description below, because if you change, I get 50 quid and so do you. So it's a win-win situation. And to be honest, even if you don't have an electric car, that 5p per kilowatt rate overnight works out way cheaper to do things like your washing if you want, or tumble drying and stuff like that. So I think it's still one of the best tariffs around, even if you don't own an electric car. Right, anyway, back to hypermiling and making my ride as smooth as possible. So I think we're coming up to about the same spot as last time. It's about to click over to 23.3 miles. There it is. And we've used 4.5 kilowatt hours of electricity, 500 watts to go. So let's see how much further we can actually go by this hypermiling. Almost at the 5 kilowatt hour mark now. Let's see. And there it is. Right, I'll take a picture of that, pause all the recording equipment, and then let's pull over and deep dive into all the statistics. So normal driving style got me 214 watt hours per mile, or 157 MPGe, which is way above what Tesla recommended it to be. But to be fair, I wasn't really doing any high speed driving because I got stuck behind Sunday drivers. The other thing to consider is the HVAC wasn't heating, it was air conditioning, which means it's going to be way more efficient because the heater is way more power intensive. So for example, as we sat here, you can see we're using about 320 watts, 360 or thereabouts. So if we turn the air conditioning on, which I think it would be air conditioning. It's not that warm in the cabin at the minute, so it might use a bit of heating. But you normally find the air conditioning will add about 1.5 overall kilowatts. So you can see we've crept up to 2 there. We're going a little bit higher. Maybe it's using a little bit of heating here. We'll soon be able to tell because it will drop straight back down again. But this might be the initial power boost as the air conditioning unit comes on. And then we'll just leave that ticking away there. I'll put it down the bottom hand corner while I talk. But then generally, I found that with the air conditioning on sat stationary, it was probably adding about 1 kilowatt hour of electricity. So not too much. Over an hour drive, you're going to be losing probably about 4 miles. So it's not going to massively impact on stuff. There you go. You can see it's now hovering around the 1.3 kilowatts. So it's added a kilowatt. Hour of electricity there. Not bad at all. I'll leave that on the screen actually, and then you can see just how that's influencing things as we go away, and I can get a little bit cooler in the cabin finally. So once I tried hypermiling, how far did I go? Drum roll, I traveled 27.3 miles, which was an extra 4 miles compared to what I got before, and an average of 183 watt hours per mile, which equates to a whopping 184 MPGe. That's just incredible how big that is. Show me another car company that can do that. That gets you a whopping 5.46 miles per kilowatt hour. So on Octopus's rate, that would cost you less than a penny a mile. Now REGEN on that journey actually contributed 2.77 kilowatt hours. Now I didn't realize REGEN influenced the range so much, but that's a massive amount. That was almost half the energy I used again from REGEN braking alone. But interestingly, the first journey got slightly more at 2.79. So the REGEN braking in that journey didn't make any difference to the range and how I drove. But as I said, I was stuck behind those slower drivers. So I think that was the key difference there. But yeah, regen braking, amazing the impact it has on your range. So if you're the type of person that used to leave your fuel light on, then freewheel down the hills or put the clutch in at every opportunity to get to the petrol station, you can do a similar thing when it comes to electric cars, and it does get you a few extra miles. Hope you enjoyed that little experiment. If you did, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, let me know why in the comments below. Also, don't forget to subscribe, especially as I've got more geeky videos coming out like this. Thanks for watching. I'll see you again soon.